What would your life look like and who would you be if you never, ever stressed out again? I mean, how much happier would be if you never worried about anything ever again? Well, today I'm going to open up a new way of thinking that will let you take the first step to leaving worry and stress behind forever. This is Zen in a Moment. It's a podcast where you can learn to train your brain to stop stressing forever and be the cool, awesome, fabulous woman you know you can be. I provide tips and strategies that will move you from being stressed out to in the flow. And by flow, what I mean is feeling light, open, and wise. I'm your host, Zen Cryer DeBrook, and I am a stress as guidance expert. So I want to talk to you about your personal stress today. You know, when you think about it for a second, you probably realize that you stress about the same things over and over and over again. I mean, most of us do. We'd love to say that the stress is coming from the outside world, that it's our to-do list. It's the monkey wrenches that people throw in our way. Maybe our husband or our boss or somebody throws new stuff in. Let me give you an example of what I'm talking about as far as stress. And by the way, when I say stress, what I mean is all of these things: worry, fear, anxiety, overwhelm, frustration, irritation. These are just some of the things, defensiveness, right? These are just some of the experiences that we face that literally show up as a physical sensation that we call stress in our body. So this is what happens. You've got your week planned. You've got a ton of things that you have to get accomplished at work, projects that are due. You've got a bunch of after-school stuff with your kids that you're trying to accomplish. It's your turn to do all kinds of various tasks, pick up the dry cleaning, you know, make snacks, get the lunches ready, do the grocery shopping, all these things. And then all of a sudden, Wednesday comes and your school calls and your kid is sick and you have to go pick them up. You've got two huge projects that are due that day that must be in, and you've already had to put them out another 2 days because it's just been a hectic week already with you having to do all these things. And then your husband calls and says he has to go away on an emergency business trip, that he's going to be gone overnight. It's your turn to bring the snacks to that soccer practice, and also your kid has a paper due, the other one that's not sick, the next day that you needed to help him with yesterday, but you didn't have time to do it. All of a sudden, your well-planned world begins to fall apart. Now, what happens inside of you? Well, for most of us, the way that we respond to stress is unique to us. So, for instance, for me, I may immediately begin feeling intensely upset and angry that I have to do it all. My stress comes from being really frustrated and irritated that all of these things are on my plate and I don't have enough help. That is the way that my mom responded to this kind of stress. For other people, they'll immediately jump to another train of thought, which is how they're going to look bad. They're going to look bad to their boss. They're going to look bad to the other parents in the soccer, because maybe it's the third time that you're going to be buying store-bought goods where Betsy, the perfect mom, makes the snacks from home because she stays at home, and she's, not that there's anything wrong with staying at home, but she has, seemingly has, time to do that. You begin to compare yourself. You begin to see how others are going to see you, and your stress comes from failing to show up as you would want to show up around these other people. Maybe your stress comes from the fact that your child is not doing well in school, and once again, you're going to have to give up giving the kind of care and attention to that report that you wanted to, and you've already had issues with this teacher. So let me explain to you this. It doesn't matter what happens in the outside world. What matters is how your mind interprets it and creates your stress for you. That stress, that way that you deal with the world around you internally, is unique to you. And it's something that was programmed. You inherited it from your surroundings as a little kid. What your mom and your dad stressed about financially, or around health, around what the neighbors think, you know, kind of thing, or whether they're being a good parent, or the stress of the pressure from their parents on them to do well or be a parent in a particular way. You watched that happening. And your mind began to create its own way of dealing with the outside world, and it shows up the way they did. Now, here's the thing that's most important about this. No matter how calm or how controlled and planned your outside world is, you will still stress out. Let's take finances, for instance, as an example. I've worked with hundreds of people in different financial situations. And I've watched them go, some of them, from being financially mediocre to actually really having quite a bit of financial success, and yet the internal experience of stress around money stayed the same. Even though they had more money, they still, their mind, still found a reason to stress. And your mind will do that too. Now, I'm here to tell you that there is a tool that you can use that I'm going to teach you about in these podcasts little by little so that you can take control of your stress and forever learn to reprogram your mind to de-stress, to not stress or worry anymore. I promise this is a real reality and it feels amazing. I've worked with hundreds of people in teaching them these same tools and it feels amazing inside when you feel light, open, and wise. No matter what the world throws at you, you're able to, what I do, pivot and change it. But in the meantime, if you're new to this podcast and you have not experienced your own internal guidance system, please go to zeninamoment.com and there's a video there where I walk you through physically feeling the experience of your internal guidance system. And what I promise you is you've been feeling this your whole life. It's something that you were born with that's here to help you de-stress. It's here to help you be present and think of new exciting ways to feel calm and open easily in any situation. So here's the thing that I want to share with you today, the little small practice, and that is it's really important for you to become aware of your stress themes, what it is that stresses you out. I know that this may sound like, well, how do I do that? It's really simple. I would love for you to either write it down in a little journal or a little piece of paper. You can keep a 3x5 card in your purse if you want. But I'd love for you to just notice throughout the day what causes you to stress out. Is it not having enough time? Is it what people will think of you? Is it failing as a parent? Is it fear of not having enough money? Maybe a bill comes in that you were not quite expecting to be as large as it is. I've had some medical bills come up recently from an emergency room visit with my son. You know how these kids do that, right? And I can tell you, when the bill came in, it was higher than I thought. What you do with it? Where does it take you? Does it take you, let's say that financial bill takes you to, oh my gosh, not having enough, or fear of your future retirement because there's this money that you want to set aside for retirement is going to go to this medical bill. Your own mind will lead you down the path. Is what we want to discover. What are your stress themes? And the reason why this is so important is because your stress themes that are unique to you will not change unless you take notice of them and you begin to realize that you're closed, that your internal guidance system is closed with these exact same things and they happen over and over and over. And by closed, what I mean is you're feeling tight. You feel a sick feeling in your stomach. You feel a tightness in your chest, a lump in your throat. When you feel tight, that means what you're thinking is not true or not going to happen. And that's where the stress comes from. It comes from thoughts that are not true or not going to happen. Think about it for a second, how much you've stressed about things in the past. How often does it come true? When you have a thought that is unpleasant or scary and it's true, you actually feel a calm sense of knowing, a feeling like you need to fix that thing right away. You need to shift it. The first step in shifting and knowing why you stress is to understand what your personal stress themes are. And they're unique. Even if your stress theme is caring what other people think, it could be you're comparing yourself to what other people think. It could be you feel like you have, once again, can't measure up to their expectations of you, concerned that they're not going to like you. There's a likeness factor that's your stress level that's going on right there, right? Or they're going to give up on you. They're not going to give you a second chance like teachers, right? So here's the thing. Find your stress themes and notice them because those are the things that you want to be attention. You're like, oop, here comes that stream of thought that's not true. It's not going to be helpful and it's only going to cause me misery. All right? So if for more information, I would love for you to go to zeninamoment.com. We have tons of resources there for you to be able to learn how to move through stress in your life forever. I promise in doing these tips and strategies, you will actually become calmer. The things that used to stress you out and be painful for you will begin to shift and go away. And you'll be able to quickly in the moment focus on what is going to be successful for you to where you can feel light, open, and wise. All right. Thank you so much for listening to this podcast. I come to you twice a week and I'm thrilled to have you listening. And until you listen again, I want you to know that I'm sending you love and blessings.